Let's see if I can convince you in about 2 minutes to go for a ride around Rookwood if you're ever in the vicinity. It's not bad at this time of the year over in the old area, lots of flowers out. Rookwood's a pretty big area, denoted by this blue line, and we're only doing the top kind of northeast corner in this video, not much at all. So we're starting over on Centenary Drive, and we're riding across the lights at Warina Road. When I ride in, I usually prefer to stay on the path. It's just a little bit easier. And then there's this kind of gateway you can cut in through here. Don't often see pedestrians around here. Everyone who comes here seems to drive. Nice, smooth roads, fairly narrow. Obviously, there's the parking lane on the side is blocked off, so you have to ride out on the road. What I like to do, I like to come up to this old area. And each year, they normally have this hidden Rookwood sculptures thing. It's closed for this year, but Baybug normally does a ride there every year, and it's well worth going and having a look at when it's open, but it's in the old section, not the new sections. This is why I'm up in the northern corner. And it gets a bit rough up here because, you know, people haven't been buried up here for about like 50 years, I guess, and so it's just tracks and all the rest of it. Not the best on a road bike if you've got slicks, and yeah, don't try this. I thought afterwards, after seeing some wallabies and rabbits bounding around, that grass is probably full of snakes. Yeah. You can see here that, you know, it's all gravel, dirt, crushed rock, etc. I've ridden through here on a mountain bike. It's pretty good. Like I said, road bike, I was riding along here thinking probably not the best place in the world to get a puncture or split a tire. If you are going cross country, you do have to watch out for these drains that are scattered across the place. You really do need to stick to the paths, and, you know, obviously be respectful and all the rest of it. But look, some of these old graves are really interesting to look at, and particularly the ones from the 1800s. It was just incredible how many kids were, you know, dying of disease and all the rest of it. Kind of makes you, you know, think vaccines are not a bad idea. Getting out of here, yeah, it's pretty boring, just, you know, straight road. There's a cafe up at this roundabout, never tried it, don't know what it's like. Here I'm coming out on the road, ducking up onto the path to press the button to get across the lights, and off we go. We're back on the normal kind of route. Now, if you're interested in doing these kind of rides, you can join Baybug. This I'll copy this into the description to give you an idea of the kind of ride that would normally happen. Here's the rides page from Baybug if you're interested in having a look. Here's some photos that were taken by Baybug members in previous years of the kind of stuff that's there if you're interested in having a look. Cyclist in coffins, not the best thing. We do have a playlist of these types of rides if you want to go through and have a look. One of these actually describes how to get here along the Greenway in the Cooks River. And what else have we got? Well, this playlist of rides is constantly growing, so you know, there'll be more things appearing in the future. And if you want to join Baybug, there'll be a link in the description to the Baybug homepage.